Asian markets ended the event-filled week on a mixed note. Most equities in the region rose in early trade before paring those gains as they digested the Fed's policy decision and its message of careful interest rate cuts. Japan's Nikkei 225 and Australia's ASX 200 closed in positive territory, while Chinese markets fell as investors stayed in the sidelines on the last day of China's National People's Congress. Here at home, Philippine shares fell for a third day, with the main index falling down to the 6,900 level and notching its third weekly loss.
Considering the recent dip in the market, investors could consider adopting a more selective approach as the market is currently facing uncertainties due to geopolitical and economic factors such as trade policies and foreign relations and also global supply chains. So right now, our current stock picks involve the energy sector, especially those involved in renewable energy or those that have strong domestic energy supply contracts. Consumer staples, which are usually resilient and consider it as safe haven stocks during these times of uncertainties and less sensitive to macroeconomic swings.
In a notable stock movement in the region, shares of Nissan plunged 6% a day after the Japanese automaker said it would cut 9,000 jobs and 20% of its manufacturing capacity. That's as it struggles with sales in China and the U.S. Tesla opens its first store in the Philippines in a move seen to boost the local EV industry. Jackie Pascual tells us what models are available and how much in this report.
Tesla has officially arrived in the Philippines with the opening of its first ever Tesla Experience Center at Uptown Bonifacio in Taguig. Special Assistant to the President for Investment and Economic Affairs, Secretary Frederick Go, and Trade Secretary Cristina Roque welcomed Tesla at the launch activity, with Roque even riding one of the electric vehicles.
Tesla has presence in about 50 countries around the world. Tesla business is a direct business. We pick our preferences. So I pick Philippines is the next new market in the world.
The Elon Musk firm unveiled the Model Y and Model 3 units with a special Philippine price tag between 2.1 million pesos to 3.3 million pesos depending on the model. The range varies from around 455 kilometers to 629 kilometers and top speed of 201 to 262 kilometers per hour.
It's the most affordable. I don't see any cars in this range or this category with this kind of pricing. It's gonna wow the market.
The National Development Company, an attached agency of the DTI, is happy with the presence of Tesla, saying it can further boost the EV industry in the Philippines.
The price range of the EVs here, I think they're one of the lowest in the market, if not the lowest. So with a brand like Tesla, that's good news for the Filipino consumer.
NDC adds it will help through the Philippine Innovation Hub to educate Filipinos on the benefits of EVs, especially on the environment. Alliance Global CEO Kevin Tan is also happy with the opening of Tesla at its Mega World property. He says a Tesla supercharger station is also expected to open at Uptown Mall and soon in other Mega World sites.
They will deploy all their charging stations all over our malls and our properties already. They're looking at our hotels as well and our townships. So there's quite a number of charging areas, charging stations that they will be deploying.
Tesla says a full charge costs only 1,140 pesos.
Can charge up 120 kilometers in 5 minutes, 19 peso per kilowatt. It's a cost of less than one-third of the gasoline cost in this country.
The Tesla Design Studio will also soon open, where Filipinos can customize the vehicle's exterior, interior, and other features. The first set of delivery for the new Tesla cars is expected in early 2025. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.